Welcome back to the Two Thrones.
Kind of crawling in my skin, and fortunately this time the wounds will heal, so...
Okay, for a second, I thought Tia was gonna say welcome back to the Tomb Raider.
Alright.
Yeah, the texture of the water in the fountain makes it look like he's drinking sand.
To be fair, this is a remaster of a PS2 game, isn't it?
Yes. GameCube, also GameCube, and I think also the Xbox, the original Xbox. Now, here's the thing. This room has a cool puzzle inside where you need to move a statue in order to free the people inside by opening the right door, the front door. However, it takes a bit too much because you need to go back and forth between some platforms, so I decided to speed it up a bit. You will see in a second. But I do believe it's a very nice touch because it's kind of symbolic of the prince has to use a statue of his father, the ruler of Babylonia, to smash the door, even though sacrificing the statue.
This has some puzzle solving elements into it, right?
Yes.
Puzzle
basically,
platform,
you need to use two separate levels to rotate the.
God.
You need to rotate the statue and to move it forward.
What song is this?
It's the puzzle thing from the first lightning game.
Actually, no, it's the Pandora's Box one.
Yeah.
Remember, I prefer that one because
the
it's
Pandora's Box better. One
oh,
adds
yeah,
a.
Yeah, that's right. They sound so similar. I forgot.
It's the same tune, but the Nishiura added a little bit extra instrumentation in the second
just
game.
Just like Maya's theme in Justice for All.
Yeah.
There you go. As you can see, you just need to roll it because you need to pass through specific types of obstacles. So it's back and forth. So I decided to just speed it up.
I think too the rumble theme from Last Spectre would have fit better here.
I suppose.
The one for the record, the one where they're chasing the Birdman in Last Spectre. I think that would have fit better.
Last Spectre might have worked for the best. You know, the one during that. Certain
anyway,
season.
Here we go.
Personally, I think the. Jeopardy theme.
FMV.
Cinematic action.
And there you go. This basically.
I don't see any QTEs in here, Joker.
And there you go. This basically means that the prince has now cared about the people. And there you go. The guy at the beginning of the second game, the one that predicted the prince would have a bad future, now instead is here to actually rally the people and recognize the prince as their savior.
God, the prince's CGI model looks.
Anyway, no time to waste because we need to chase that other enemy with the chariot. Time for another one. Yay.
I think you're taking this hero.
It's daytime now!
Also,
and now I'm Ben-Hur now.
Yeah,
not Ben-Hur. I'm still... I can still recall being dizzy after seeing that movie.
The remake of the original, please.
The remake.
Like, I don't even know why they bother doing that.
Well, it flopped, so...
It with Vic Valji, that's your marketing, so, yeah.
I had to see... Well, I saw Kubo immediately after, so...
Great.
Not all bad, I guess.
But yeah, actually, that the chariot sequences, which are only two in this game, the one we did before in this one... We're actually heavily promoted in the marketing of this game. I don't know why.
I mean, I can see why, Maple. They definitely seem like a nice, fun change of pace, but apparently there's only two. Which
yeah,
is kind of
and
they're
not even
fun,
that fun,
actually.
The controls are, like I said, the controls are a bit stiffy. And the enemy that you're chasing is not just a regular Muku, but... The next boss, which will transition in after the sequence.
A boss looks a bit like a gladiator.
A bit, yeah. You'll see. Also, yeah, we
even have sir, you're in my way.
You're in my way, sir. Yeah, the enemies try to impeach you, but...
And now this has me imagining if the Warthog sections in Crash Bandicoot 1 have that time traveling power.
Actually, I was thinking more of the Tiger levels from Crash Warped, since
with
that one had time travel.
Kind of.
I guess it's just like, well, the way the horse and the prince get knocked over reminds me so much of the Warthog. Yeah. Excuse me, pardon me, sidestep, coming through.
I love how the enemy tries to grab the chariot, but he immediately...
Oh no!
Oh no.
Why did he think that was a good idea?
Well, it got him off
because
the chariot.
Unfortunately, it's not just one enemy, but a set of twins.
Alright,
I
will admit,
I was not expecting that. Nope.
Or that.
Escape may not be an option.
Now, here's... This part is actually really interesting. One brother cannot be damaged, while the other you need to wait until he does that move in order to damage it properly. At least for this phase.
It reminds me of that one boss right from Devil May Cry 3.
Agni Arada? No, that's actually... Actually, you can damage both at any time, but...
No, I'm just saying, fighting two bosses at once is just wrong.
Yeah. A lot of games of the PS2 era actually had these. I think God of War 2 actually had, I think, another boss like this.
Unfortunately, that's where I stopped playing the game because the game was too hard for me.
This is...
I'm not good. I'm not a real Devil May Cry fan. Bayonetta, whatever.
0 out of 10.
You're on about Devil May Cry, right? Okay.
Honestly, Devil May Cry, Bayonetta is actually even harder than the actual.
And yeah, I beat both of them.
The thing is, too, Bayonetta actually does have an easy mode. Devil May Cry, the first one at least, does not have a difficulty selection.
Yeah, but it does actually. But
it does?
I beat Bayonetta on normal.
Oh.
Both games.
Spinners
maybe,
need to check.
I'm guessing Bayonetta appealed to you for certain
reasons? It's the witch time ability.
Ah,
but there you go. Fair actually came back.
I guess a saving a building of burning people probably convinced her that we're on the level.
Thank you. Lucky shot. I'm sure more are on the way.
Didn't she just walk away? Did you notice that?
Yes.
Did you notice that? Like the prince literally jump cut out of existence in the very last frame of the cutscene.
Anyway, for this next one, basically, you can tell that part of the game was actually cut out because we're jumping directly, kind of not to the climax, but almost. Now the prince and Pharah and the remaining citizens of Babylonia will face the remaining army of sand creatures outside the palace, while using this as a diversion, while Pharah and the prince sneaks inside the palace to take out. The vizier.
Roll the credits!
This is basically a simple redemption moment. The fact that the prince managed in the end to help these people out actually pays off by them helping him in his moment of need. It should have been handled a bit better, honestly. Also, yeah, can you tell that the developers really love Lord of the Rings?
Yeah.
We cannot kill these creatures, but we can slow them. Go, prince, find the vizier and finish him.
Mono e mono! Or
yes.
Mono e abomination o.
Also, this cut. Yeah, the fact that Reese's Knight makes these cutscenes a bit too dark for their taste.
It's weird because, you know, because of the actual animation in game, it's daytime still.
Yeah, well, now it's night.
Ah, well, now it is.
Like I said, the game jumps a bit. I'll be with you soon. I need to find a way to
open this door. Does it involve possibly killing enemies and dispersing their sand into it, I wonder?
Surprisingly, no. I thought there would have been a mechanism here to this, but no.
Especially considering the timing.
Jesus. But anyway, yeah, let me also explain this to you, Deji, quickly, might as well. The transition between the normal type of the prince and his dark side actually affects the combat, as you can see. That chain is actually really easy to make the combat really easier. It's kind of similar to what... I forgot which year came out, James, can you help me on this one? Castlevania Lament of Innocence for the PS2.
Let me check Chrome.
Because it really does feel a bit like an old weep game of the 3D Castlevania games.
Swinging the chain, swinging the chain.
Alright, just checking when did Castlevania Laments of Innocence come out?
Wikipedia. In Japan, Innocence saw a re-release under the Konami Dendu Collection label on March 2nd, 2006.
Thank
the
you,
game was the PlayStation Network.
Shut up, I get it. Thank you.
don't be mean to her. Come on.
But I got the answer. I don't need to hear anymore.
Yeah, you don't have to say shut up. You can just say that'll do. That'll do.
Yeah, but it won't respond. It won't respond to that anyway. So.
But saying shut up makes it better, huh?
It's more direct.
Talk about abusive.
Deji,
you know what? You are the problem with the society.
Guys, it's more short and to the point. If I said what Deji told me to suggest, I'd be there for all day.
So at this point, you might as well just type in the answer instead of actually asking it.
And it would keep firing back at me.
Never work in retail.
Excuse me, Mr. Excuse me, Mr. Charlie Manson. Could you please stop stabbing me?
Also, you may have seen that the Air of the Prince just clipped out at some point. Like I said, this is the less glitchy of the three games, but it's not exempt from that.
I have to wonder if this is more so just the HD porting, because from what we've seen, the original PS2 versions look better in a lot of areas.
Especially where within, like, it was an entire comparison. Anyway, Katari.
Anyone home?
Those amazing hair physics. Like, his hair is constantly moving.
You know, when I
stabbed. God, don't put me close to her face, please.
Hold on, I think we're about to get a moment of bonding between the two.
Oh, okay.
So is she gonna die at the end of this, or...?
No. We already killed off one love interest. I do
hope to visit Azaz. Hey man, look at how many love interests Daniel Craig had.
Anyway, since Farrah is not really that acrobatic, sadly, we need to find a way to move the elevator where she stands in.
So that she can help us back.
See, there you go, Teo. See, that's what they always should do. Have that subtitle there saying you have collected X things instead of stopping with a...
That's the thing. Warrior Within had the subtitle, so why did they remove that from here?
I don't know.
Okay, serious question. Why is it that HD ports of this time and age were often bad, like to the point where they made them look worse?
Because Bluepoint was still not in business.
Not just that. After the success of the God of War collection, which was the one the worst of it pioneered the remastering of the PS2 titles for the PS3, a lot of companies wanted to jump ship on that for a quick buck. And Ubisoft was clearly among these.
Ubisoft was doing the whole, we want to clearly capitalize on something, but we don't understand
I forgot if I told you, but basically that for comparison, the Beyond Good and Evil HD version actually fares more better than these. So at least we got that right. I haven't seen the HD version of Rayman 3, so I cannot tell.
They got rid of matter.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
They got rid of matter, the main theme song.
Really? Why?
Because that was a licensed song.
Oh, okay.
That's understandable.
Yeah.
It's you know, kind of like how to get on a Sonic
also, like when in Okami, for the HD versions of Okami, they actually removed the credit song because it's an actual song that also was licensed. When I plan to record in the game, I'm still gonna re-implement that because it's like, from what I've seen from experience, it's not actually copyrighted on YouTube. So it
I recently got Okami HD.
It's fun, but it's gonna take you time and patience because it's structured like a Zelda game. So be mentally prepared for that.
Ah, crap! I've never beaten a Zelda game before. Oh no!
Have you played the Darksiders games?
No.
Dark Souls?
Speaking of Darksiders, you know 3 is coming out like this week?
Oh yeah!
Actually, yes. I'm not looking rough.
And I've seen nobody be hyped for it because
You'll be surprised, Edge, instead. But that actually leaves me instead of, also speaking of the remasters, that leaves me also actually on talking on a good topic instead of what THQ Nordic is doing at the moment. Because they're basically becoming my new favorite Western company at the moment.
THQ Nordic are pretty much like EA if they're good guys. They're THQ buying, Nordic are buying companies, but for good
they're
purposes.
They're buying a shitload of forgotten IPs and basically remastering them on most system possible.
We're even getting the Nickelodeon GameCube era games.
Supposedly. And keep in mind, since we're adopting a low risk strategy of not putting too much budget even into new games, they basically are guaranteed to have incomes even low sales. One of the developers of Darksiders 3 said pretty much freely that the game can easily bomb and the developers and publishers will not care and still move on.
That's actually a smart move, especially with consoles like the Nintendo Switch coming out, which will give a great...
The downside is that if a port comes out not really right, like some console version of Titan Quest, unfortunately there's not much that can be done with that. Yes, Pedro?
Yeah. I'm trying to cross my fingers, hoping that they'll buy Interplay's IPs to see if we can get some really good releases over from Jim.
Hey, you know, I actually would be surprised if they managed to pull that off.
Because the definitive way of playing the first game is still the old Sega CD version, so...
THQ Nordic, to me, are pretty much what
Didn't they do a hand-drawn remake?
No, Deji. That's the thing, Deji. It was not hand-drawn. It was it was made by Gameloft, the creators of Sonic Unleashed Mobile and Sonic... yes.
And they also do Disney Magic Kingdom, which is a better game, but that's only because they have the backing of Disney.
It's a very cheaply made remake, Deji, and it wasn't even based on the definitive special edition of the Sega CD. It was based on the Mega Drive version, which demonstrates that the developers did not know what they were doing, because if they knew, they would have based it off the Sega CD.
I mean, don't get me wrong, the Mega Drive version does have some cool benefits, like it has the best versions of certain tunes. Oh, wait, no, those got remade, so what was even the point?
Yeah. It is true. Oh, Deji. Hello, Deji's mom. No, Joe was right. I agree that the tracks of New Junk City and Buttville's
the first end.
Yeah. Technically, Jova, the official name as given by Tommy in his albums is Falling, but whatever. The point is, those tracks are actually better on the Mega Drive, I agree with that. But the Sega CD still has extra content, and overall just better stuff all around, more animations, also. It's still definitely the version to play. So it doesn't really make any sense that they would I guess they should be grateful that they didn't remake the Super Nintendo version, at least, I guess.
Well, what reason would they have to do that? It's literally just the Sega Genesis version, but with screen crunch. Oh, and some color changes.
Hey, you know what game I would really like to be re-released, but it will never happen?
What?
The Super Nintendo version of Turtles in Time.
Not just that, oh yeah.
Where's the license of
Konami?
Konami
too. Konami has always been the one who's always made the TMNT games.
Then
Activision, I think. Anyway, hold on a moment, because we're about to get another bonding moment.
Okay.
Elevator.
Yes.
Oh, it's even got cushions to sit on.
Color?
Shall I read the question?
Blue.
Blue? That's not my favorite color.
What is the point of this?
Must every conversation we have be so serious? I know so little about you.
Very well.
I mean, I just found out that you have a demonic entity within you. I think I would like to know a bit more.
Yeah, that's why I keep running away from him. Wait.
What is wrong with you?
They are messy, impossible to eat with dignity. So much work for a few seeds.
But is it not the effort that makes them that much sweeter?
I don't know why, but his arm reminds me of Nier.
Yeah, the mocap and facial animations haven't really aged well.
No.
That's my issue with her. I mean, she just said, "I don't know much about you." That's just because you keep running away from her.
I mean, she had her reasons beforehand. Again, I can't help but... Watch out! Oh, snap. Again,
nah,
I can't
see... Two girls with swords.
Again, I can't help but feel like a lot of these animations look better in the PS2 version as well.
No, they're the same. We just have a better textures for the model, possibly.
Well, that's my point. Different textures.
We didn't add the entire layer of shader that was removed for some reason in the HD version.
That's sort of my point. Different textures lead to different animations. In fact, I really do not recall this much clipping in the original PS2 version because the textures synced up properly. Here, the textures are on so many different levels that, of course, they cut through each other.
Mm-hmm.
Also, the reminder that Kylie, we got that scene with Kylina leaving her eyes behind where she was teleporting.
You know, that kind of actually makes me wonder. Do you think THQ Nordic might be able to buy Prince of Persia if Ubisoft doesn't care or two hoots about it anymore?
I would see that as a potential possibility, but I'm not seeing Ubisoft willing to sell any of its IPs at the moment. So,
it depends. I mean, Prince of Persia, like I said, they don't seem to give two hoots about Prince of Persia these days, so maybe they might be willing more to sell that. They're obviously not going to sell something like Rabbids or Assassin's Creed. Speaking of which, they went to so much trouble to have Watch Dogs be part of the universe, yet I don't think we'll be hearing any news about Watch Dogs 3 anytime soon, considering...
That's because
Watch Dogs 2 did
not sell so well.
Can we,
Which is a shame, because I heard it's a lot better than the first one, but it's just...
Here's the problem. First one happened.
Can we have THQ Nordic take Sierra's IPs away from Activision? That would be nice.
I would love that, but we all know Activision is only going to let the likes of Crash, Spyro, and company go when they've milked them dry.
Well, actually, I'm in Sierra's IPs, okay, King's Quest, Space Quest, the works.
Oh,
surprisingly enough, from what they've discovered, Leisure Suit Larry is not even in Activision's hands for some reason. It's something, it's like an indie publisher or something.
That's because Teo, Allo did manage to get... Well, actually, Dwebs, the recent Leisure Suit Larry game that released is actually really good. Wet Dreams Don't Dry, yeah. It's actually pretty faithful to the original games. It's a new game made by an indie studio, Jova.
But hang on, Pedro. Based on what I've been hearing about some of the letters about Leisure Suit Larry, apparently being faithful to the previous games means it sucks.
Well, that's the thing, Dwebs. Again,
there's this thing going around that apparently everyone hates that series because it's old and dated. And
that's the thing, Dwebs. That the game was made purely for fans, aka people who like Sierra putting click adventure games. Obviously, if the problem is that those kinds of games are not really the hot thing anymore, you know.
I mean, they are in some avenues, but it depends on the ratio or whatnot. Like, Laser Shoot Larry is a game that pretty much lives and breathes on click and points and whatnot.
And
now,
humor,
there is definitely a place for those kind of games. The thing is, like, normally
it's
or whatnot...
Also,
when
we play Ace Attorney.
Let me finish.
Unlike King's Quest or Space Quest, Laser Shoot Larry is dwelled into sexual humor, so adult humor instead of just being also for kids.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, and like that said, games like Ace Attorney are still successful to this day. Granted, Ace Attorney does have the visual aspects to help it. Not to say Leisure Suit Larry doesn't. It's just you can definitely tell which is more based around one or another. That said, that doesn't make it bad, though. Just more niche.
The problem is that a lot of people nowadays seem to view the old point-and-click adventure games as something
that's
outdated and shouldn't really exist anymore, which baffles me.
It's just like 3D platformers.
It's the equivalent of a debate between action RPGs and turn-based combat, so yeah. Anyway, see you for the next part.
See you
then.